So if you haven't heard yet, Nigel Houston left Element Skateboard. I think we can all see now that Element is crumbling, and I think Nigel saw the writing on the wall and left, as well as Dominic Walker and Chris Cookie Colburn. So now with Element out of the picture, the question is, where is Nigel gonna go next? In my last video that I made about this, there was a lot of comments suggesting two companies that kept coming up over and over was Primitive Skateboards and April Skateboards, just based off the fact that their teams are full of the most elite skateboarders. April Skateboard, you've got Shane O'Neill and Yuto Horigome, and they're still a young company. They've also got Diego Najera, and then Primitive, obviously, I mean, you've got P-Rod, Spencer Hamilton, Frankie Villani, Trevor McClung, Giovanni Viana, Miles Silva. And although these are some of the biggest companies with the biggest names in the industry, I personally don't think that this is a good fit for Nigel Houston. Think how many people have actually had pro shoes on Nike skateboarding. We're talking P-Rod, Eric Costin, Stefan Janoski, Nigel Houston. Leave it in the comments below if there's more that I missed, but we're talking about some of the all-time greats. That is the level that Nigel Houston is at. And if you look at Eric Costin, what has he done? He started his own companies. You look at Paul Rodriguez, same thing, started his own companies because they understand that there is more value in them building their own project than it is for them to just get $2 chucked to them per board that they sell. I think the move for Nigel is to start his own company. Paul Rodriguez and Primitive, yes, Paul Rodriguez started Primitive. Yes, he's the owner and founder, but he's still able to run a business and skate, and it's because he's put other people in charge that are running the business for him so he can continue being a professional skateboarder. And I think Nigel Houston would be crazy to not take a page out of Paul Rodriguez's book and go ahead and start his own project and get people behind him that can run the company for him while he continues to dominate contest skating and put out some of the craziest video parts that we've ever seen. Despite the fact that I think Nigel would be crazy to not start his own company, there is one other board company that I do think would make sense for Nigel to switch to. Before we talk about what company I think would be a good fit for Nigel Houston, we're gonna do some tricks and get warmed up and then check back in just a second. One company that I do think would be a good fit for Nigel Houston. It's actually one of the newest companies in the skateboard industry, founded by the same guy that started Element way back in the early 2000s. So just last year, the founder of Element actually left Element Skateboard and started his own company again, but this time it's called the Heart Supply Co. This company basically gives back to kids in need who can't afford to buy their own skateboard. They've got some notable names on their team. For one, Chris Chan, who everybody knows if you're watching YouTube. I know Jagger Eaton is also on their team, but all in all, this company is still really young and really new. However, they have a veteran at the head, Johnny Schilleriff, who was the founder of Element, who Nigel Houston had a really close and personal relationship with. There's two big reasons why I think it could be a good move for him. Number one, no responsibility. He wouldn't have to run a company while focusing on skating. He already makes plenty of money skating contests with his endorsements, so switching to another board company would keep his life a little bit more stress-free. But the biggest reason I think that I could see this happening is because Nigel has such a good relationship with Johnny Schilleriff. I could see Nigel Houston buying in and investing a lot of money into the company, the Heart Supply Co., to help Johnny Schilleriff, but then also to be a part of a board company that is such a good cause. The Heart Supply Co. is a passion project for Johnny Schilleriff, just like Element was when he started it way back in the early 2000s. But now Johnny Schilleriff has even more experience after 20 years of running a skateboard company. I think that this possibly could work for Nigel. It would allow him to be more stress-free and focus on his skating. It might also make financial sense and be a good middle ground between starting your own company and taking on a ton of responsibility versus writing for another company and just making $2 a board. Ultimately, he needs to go someplace where he has the freedom to do whatever he wants to do, whether that be starting his own company or investing in the Heart Supply Co. I think to me, those are the two options that make the most sense for Nigel. Thank you. So one thing that's so sick about Nigel Houston is he's pretty much done everything there is to do in skateboarding. He has dropped the most insane video part, won all the contests, X Games, Street League, everything. But what's so crazy about him is he's still learning new tricks. He posted this video on his Instagram just earlier this week. It's a switch heel, switch front tail, switch front big spin out. But still at his level, he's still pushing it, trying to get better and better every single day. So if Nigel Houston's learning new tricks, then I can learn a new trick. So today I'm gonna try and learn front board 270 out. I don't know how I'm gonna learn this trick, but sometimes the pressure of the camera gets you to do things that you couldn't do otherwise. So see if I can get this trick. Front board 270, let's get it. So finally, to wrap up this video, I want to know what you guys think is the best next move for Nigel Houston. If you think he should move to a board company, start his own company. I know there's a lot of theories and different opinions going around out there, so I'm curious to hear what you guys have to say. If you like the videos that I make and you want to support my channel, don't forget to subscribe and like the video so more people can see it. And let me know in the comments below what kind of videos you guys want to see. Thank you for everybody that's new to my channel, and I will see you guys in a few days. Peace. Thank you.